two pretty entertaining games. You couldn't ask for much more in a college weekend. Took obviously two wins, but
yeah, exactly. But you know, just the way we played, and I think the way Miami played. I've been associated with hockey a long time, and I don't remember two games that were that exciting from start to finish, and the different momentum swings in both games that teams went through. And I mean, it was just a toe-to-toe battle from start to finish for 125 plus minutes, including the shootout. Which, hey, if I'm a fan and I'm in the stands, I don't know why we don't have that in place, because that's just exciting hockey, you know, at the end. So, but it was great. I certainly appreciate Miami's style of play. You know, they're a great team, and they play hockey the way it should be played. You know, a lot of talent from their defensive core through their forwards. I mean, there isn't a non-talented player on that team, and they're fun to watch, tough to play against. Feel very fortunate that we were able to come away with a win and a tie and a shootout victory.
What about your young goalie tonight?
Hey, he saw a little bit of everything tonight. You know, I thought we did a much better job on the penalty kill tonight against our power play. I mean, they had puck possession, but they didn't see a lot of shot opportunities. But when they did, I thought Rob was played really big in that tonight. You know, he swallowed pucks, he made a couple of huge saves. We backed in on him a little bit at times. I think we were honoring their speed, and a couple of those shots were tough for him. He saw last minute goals I'm referring to. But very proud of him. And then to go into a shootout, you know, his first collegiate hockey game and do as well as he did, I think it was great for him. It would be great for his confidence.
Coach, talk about the guys' resilience. 1-0 game, they score in the second to go up 2-0, and you come back with two quick ones to tie it up.
Well, it was. I mean, that's a great question, because that's what I just said to our team. You know, we could have gone the other way. You know, we were throwing everything we had at them, and we had some good scoring opportunities, but we just weren't able to put one by them. We get down 2-0, and then we have a couple of shifts where it didn't look great. They had us kind of back on our heels, and then Peter Lennis, I think it was the first goal that we had. Peter Lennis made that great move on their defenseman, strong effort to kind of step by their defenseman, and then found Carlson streaking to the net. Great hand-eye coordination on Tori Carlson. That really ignited our team to get back in it. And then we, you know, shortly thereafter, I think Kevin Miller put one in, didn't he? You know, so that's what I love about this team. I know the season's young, but we've had situations where I think I said it before, we would bend, but we won't break. And I think it's a great sign for our team this early to learn those lessons that, hey, we can come back when we're down 2, or, you know, then we came back when it was 3-2. There's no worry. We kept our composure the whole time, and the confidence level of the guys to believe in each other to get the job done is pretty high already.
Penalty shot, do you have any options on that? Is it just a penalty shot by then? Do you have an option of taking a penalty?
No, it goes against the player who is infracted has to shoot. And it was a great play. You know, Roloff had a great weekend, and I thought he had it, but, he would have been one of the guys we would have considered anyway. So,
Coach, what have you learned about your team, I guess, after this weekend, after performing so well against the Miami?
Well, I think, again, we feel really good about our speed and the direction of with which we're using that speed, and we were tested all weekend. You know, I mean, Miami was, you know, this was a great test for our team. They're a great program, dripping with talent, and our defensemen were challenged, our goaltending was challenged, our penalty kill, which is typically one of our best attributes, I thought, got back to it tonight. So every facet of the game we were tested, and I thought we graded very well in most categories. So again, I'm really pleased with what I've seen, our work ethic. And again, it's more of an attitude than anything. It's confidence, it's maturity, it's great leadership on the bench by our captains and our upperclassmen. So again, it's early, but this was a big test for us early, you know, to face a team that has experience of playing in the national tournament over the past few years, being ranked as high. Sometimes there's an intimidation factor, but from the start of the weekend to the final shootout goal, I thought our team handled it very well.
You mentioned that final shootout goal. What can you say about the way that Milo's come out in these first three games for you?
Well, he's got the hot stick. So we do a shootout every week, and the first three guys are kind of our steady players when we play around. Mm-hmm. So we listed those three, but we had Milo ready to go if it needed to go to the sudden death. He didn't have his helmet on, so he had to scramble and get going. But you know, he said last night he's a goal scorer. He loves to score goals, loves to shoot. I think it was fitting that he shot the puck instead of trying to make a move with the way the ice was and everything like that. So smart play by him.
He and Lennon seem to have quite the chemistry.
They do. They played really well. And again, tonight we tinkered with the lines just a little bit. I mean, we have a lot of Stacey back in the lineup. I thought he had a great first game. You know, it's kind of tough to jump into a weekend like this without having played in any games. I thought he handled himself very well. And by moving Corey Carlson on that line, again, we spread our experience a little bit, you know, our leadership a little bit. And, I thought they, you know, not only Lennis and Milo, they had key chemistry so far. I thought Carlson fit pretty nicely there as well.
And with, I guess with both Lennis and Milo, when you see the, how hot they've come out, what sort of expectations do you have for them being able to, I don't know if you're expecting Peter to go 2 points a game through the season, although you'd nice. Certainly love it.
Yeah, but. You know what, I think if they approach the game the way they've approached it, you know, every time they've stepped on the ice this year, their work ethic is really what's defining them. You know, they're putting pressure on teams, they're getting pucks to the net, they're getting to the net for rebounds. Quite frankly, they're keeping the game pretty simple. You know, if they don't have a play, they're chipping it behind the D and using their speed to get to it. I mean, if they continue to do that, they're going to have success. I certainly, you know, put expectations on players point-wise or anything like that. I just would expect their, you know, expect them to be consistent, bring that kind of effort and intensity to every game. They energize our team, so we certainly expect that for the rest of the season.
Coach, if there was one negative, two goals for them off two pretty glaring turnovers, but your
yeah.
guys overcame that.
Yeah, again, we were just talking about that in the locker room. You know, I don't know that we made them really earn those goals. You know, we had just some bad turnovers, and you know, can't fault Rob on that. We left them kind of naked. We had to earn every. It's the difference between our team and their team. Maybe in some aspects, we really had to earn every goal we had this weekend. We just got to eliminate those key turnovers and mistakes. Little miscommunications here and there, but I think if we can right that. You know, we should be a pretty good hockey team this year.
Feeling pretty good now, starting with BC coming up on Friday?
Well, you know, we're going to enjoy this weekend, you know, at least tonight, and then we'll get to work. We know Boston College is obviously one of the best teams, if not the best team on paper in the country, so it certainly doesn't get any easier as we go down our schedule, but I think our players are excited. This will give them some confidence, you know, going on against a powerful program like Miami. We'll give some of our players the confidence they need to be successful next weekend.